Short sale specialist and default advocate Mike Wrigley discusses Chase Freddie Mac short sale escalations. Hey, short sale specialist, default advocate, distressed property expert, and short sale agent Mike Wrigley here, bringing you the latest short sale information. Thanks for joining us. Today, let's talk about a recent Chase short sale where Freddie Mac was the investor. Chase recently switched to the Equator system for managing their short sales, and the general consensus about short sale specialists is it is not the best move for them. We recently received approval on one of our Chase short sales where Freddie Mac was the investor 75 days after having submitted the Chase short sale package through Equator. In our mind, that's nothing to brag about. 70 plus days, no good, no bueno. We took on the listing after the seller had tried to get the Chase short sale approved for over a year by working with another agent. With a foreclosure sale date looming in the not-so-distant future, we received an offer quickly and processed the Chase short sale package in record time. And here's where we started running into problems. For whatever reasons, we were bounced around from one Chase short sale representative to another, and because we follow up on our files twice a week, every week, we knew we were getting the runaround. We escalated the file to the Chase executive office and got the file back on track in short order. After not more than a week after the escalation, our Chase short sale negotiator told us the file was being denied because the pending foreclosure sale date was so close. Now, never mind, it was Chase's short sale department's fault who delayed the file to the point where they were now declining it. What gives? Now I'm pissed, right? So, much like a manipulative child, if you don't like the answer mom gives you, you go ask dad, and that's exactly what we did. We escalated the file directly to Freddie Mac. Because our notes are detailed and we were able to go line by line, date by date, and name by name and detail the chain of events on this file to Freddie Mac, why Chase should not only reopen the file but approve it. Evidently, our detail was strong enough, our case was strong enough, that Freddie Mac agreed, because not only do we get the foreclosure sale date postponed, the Chase short sale department issued us our approval letter. They waived the right to seek a deficiency and gave the sellers $3,000 for relocation assistance. How great is that? I'm telling you. The sellers walk away from over $400,000 in debt with no liability. They avoid the foreclosure and they get a fresh start financially. Who doesn't love a happy ending? Oh, by the way, Chase will lose much less, as will Freddie, because they lose less in a short sale than a foreclosure. Now, is a short sale right for you? I don't know. Give me a call. Let's find out. We have programs that may allow you to stay in your property after the short sale. To get a better idea of when your home will be worth, log on to www.shortsaleandloanmod.info for a free estimate, or call me today for a free, no-obligation consultation. Call me today. Sleep better tonight. You'll be glad you did, and I'll look forward to hearing from you.